So standing next to the legendary Jay Cutler, it's Sunday at the FIBO and most of the people who are working here are getting tired and exhausted, but not you. So just let me have a quote from one of your videos. What's the secret, Jay?
Longevity. I've been in this a long time. I've been at FIBO since 1999. I've been coming here, so I try to prep myself. Fortunately for me, I came in on Friday. I wasn't here on Thursday, and you know, I have my commitment to the fans, and I'm here for the fans.
Wouldn't you say that the FIBO changed since 1999? I mean, look at the people.
You know what? It's changed, but I think now fitness is becoming bigger, and I see a lot more people, a lot more different changes of people where, you know, we have so many different divisions now that people can be competitive, but people are just active in fitness. I think people are catching on to the lifestyle, and they're coming here for motivation. They're coming here to look at the products. They're coming here to interact with their with the people that they use as mentors to become better, and I think that's awesome.
But some of the longest tours have people who doesn't have the ability to compete even on a local competition. They just have the 1 million or 10 million followers on Instagram. So what's your thought on that?
I know, listen, I mean, I'm a guy that transitioned from the magazines to social media. Yes, I have the achievement of the Mr. Olympia status, and I have an abundance of fans. I have the crossover. So those people that have those fans that are social, they're also my fans too. And I think, you know, people call me the legend, which makes me a little older, but it's okay because I only set out to be my absolute best, and my career kind of spoke volume for what success is in the fitness arena and through the achievements, but also the commitment to the fans and interacting with the fans and staying at each expo and trying to just do everything I can to give back to the business that made me such a great champion and motivated me. Because listen, in the beginning, I was just a fan looking for recognition. And look, I wanted to be somebody, and I became someone just by circumstance. I tried to work my hardest to be my best, and I became the best. And now I'm just giving back, trying to help that next person get to that next level.
My quote was from the Living Large series, which is, in my opinion, one of the most motivating series you can find on YouTube. And my question is, how large do you live right now?
As large as you can live in what we do, pretty much. I am still traveling every week. I'm out there working, doing things that I really want to do now. Yes, I'm not on the competitive stage, but I'm doing much greater things now. I'm promoting shows. I'm working in a supplement, a clothing business. I'm working with the military, touring with the USO, doing so many great things, and I'm attending every trade event. I didn't get to travel a lot internationally when I was competing because I was so competitive and so driven to be in the gym that I held back a lot from the touring. So now I'm really touring a lot, being exposed to all new fans, all new cultures all around the world. So I'm living the ultimate dream. And also, I'm living in Vegas, living large too. You guys see it in all my videos. You know how I live.
Yes, of course. You still got your breakfast with two whole eggs, the three raisin toast, the grits, and the...
Two Ezekiel toast, three turkey bacon, two whole eggs, two cups of egg whites, one scoop of protein, cup of coffee, and you know, that's what keeps me on top.
And that's the breakfast of champions, so thank you very much. Good work here at the FIBO, and always good to see you here in Germany.
Always good to see you every time I'm here. I look forward to next year.